to decide a growth or below ground. Let's say I choose a below ground OSD and at the pre-development, I need to give the basic input data so that the program can perform calculation. Let's say the L, I give 1000 meter, and then the S, the slope of the overland ship flow path, then the area, the catchment area, and for this catchment, how much area is pervious or impervious? Let's say the impervious is 0.2. Once I press enter, the pervious area will be automatically updated because it will use 0.8 minus 0.2. So it will become 0.6 as I press enter. Okay, every catchment has its own efficiency. It means this catchment can capture how much runoff. Each catchment has its own efficiency, and that efficiency is measured in runoff coefficient. It means, let's say, 10 meter cube water reach to that catchment. What is the efficiency for that catchment to capture those amount of water? So this one we can refer to chart provided by MASMA. Let's say for this impervious catchment, we need to decide the site is in urban or development. Let's say it's in urban, then we have set 8 types of impervious catchment. So how does this chart work? How does it get the runoff coefficient value? The program will internally calculate what is the intensity. And then based on the type I choose, let's say the rainfall intensity is 90 mm per hour, it will internally calculate the I. Then it will go up until to the line number 1. Line number 1 is because I choose line number 1. It depends on which line we choose. Then it will read the value of C, the runoff coefficient. So this is how the chart works. How do we get the catchment runoff coefficient? The efficiency of the catchment. So let's say I choose type 1 and I click OK. So my choice will be updated here for impervious catchment, type 1. So for the impervious catchment, same chart will pop out. So we choose either urban or rural, then choose the type for impervious catchment. This one is pervious, so choose the type of pervious catchment. Normally for pervious catchment, the JPS would recommend the engineer to use type 7. Type long and middle. So I choose type 7. So the type I choose will be updated here, my choice. So based on all the input here, the program will calculate the TC. The TC is calculated based on this formula. If I do not want this default value, I can change. Once I change, the cell will be highlighted in red color, indicating it's not a default value. If I want a default value, then I click this button to get the default value. This is actually not a button, it's an indication to change this. Because initially we put some default value in, just a reminder for the user to change the default value. Okay, and then we proceed down. Choose the ARI year, depends on the receiving drain capacity. Let's say I choose 2 years. Location. Location, let's say we choose Sabah. The picture here will change indicating where is the station. Okay, and then the program will auto calculate 2B24 and FD. The 2B24 and FD only applies to short duration storm. Short duration storm is the storm duration lesser than 30 minutes. If the storm duration is larger or equal to 30 minutes, 2B24 and FD is not needed in calculating the rainfall intensity. Let's say I change to 25, these two values will be highlighted. If larger then 30 minutes or equal to 30 minutes, this two value is not needed at all, so that will be grayed out. This is the fitting coefficient, A, B, C, D, also read from the chart for MASMA. And then, here is empty here. After I click calculate, it will indicate what is the rainfall intensity one of coefficient is C, I is rainfall intensity. So this is the reason why we need to choose the type of pervious and impervious area and the area for those catchments. So this is where we optimize our design. So this is the Q3. So now we proceed to the post-development. Okay, we need to specify the L. It's very short, let's say 2 meters. The slope and the bending coefficient. There's a chart here from Masma. This is the bending coefficient and this is the surface height. If it is from root center to root section, then we choose concrete asphalt. Or is from other surface, then we choose other surface. As I click this concrete asphalt, the value here will be updated according to my selection. Here is 0.011. I click, then it change. We can also change again. Like this also can. So I just choose practice value. And the L1. L1 is the largest L from the most remote point of the grain level to the point of the charge. Let's say it's like 600. And then the D, average velocity, and the area for impervious and pervious catchment. Same input technique, same chart. So I will skip this one. And then TC, TC calculated based on T0 plus TB. T0 plus TB. And then the ARR year, 10 years. Asma already specified, this will be 10 years. And then the coefficient A, B, C, D, automatic. You fill in. If user want to change, also can. After I change, the value will be highlighted in red color. This will indicate it's not a default value anymore. Click this button to get the default value. And at the end, click calculate. It will say hydraulic structure needs to be proposed. It means the size of the OST needs to be proposed. So here it will calculate what is the rainfall intensity and what is the runoff coefficient. And this is a post-development Q3 0.4 compared to 0.052. So here it means after the development, the discharge is larger than the pre-development. So it means we cut down the trees, now the runoff on the surface has become more increased. So now we need to propose our OSD to store that increased amount of water and releasing it slowly to decrease the Q. Okay, now we go to point sizing. Here we look at the SSR value is at the most bottom row. Here we cannot tell confidently that this SSR is the most maximum value. So what setting do we need to do? We go to option, we go to OSD. It's related to SSR, so we go back to the SSR category. There's a three setting here. We look at the first one. Range of duration, 5 minutes. It means the increment is by 5 minutes. Number of range, 12. It means we have 12 rows. I go back to the OSD. There are 12 rows here. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. This is the additional factor. The maximum value of the OSD will be times by this factor, 1.2. This one is also specified by MASMA to account for construction tolerance. The maximum value of SSR need to be increased by extra 20%. Okay, so just now in order to increase the number of rows, so we increase the setting here. Let's say I increase until it to 40, that's it enough or not? 40 rows. Go back to post-development. Click again the calculate to update the calculation and go back to the pond sizing. Here we can see that the maximum SSR is at the middle area, so we can conclude that we already got the maximum value of SSR. So the basic concept of OST design is met. Okay, after that, we proceed down. Okay, in order for us to key in these two values, we need to have some assumption first. Firstly, we need to think what is the depth of the OST. The OST needs to be how much depth? Let's say I assume it to be 2 meter. I don't know if it will pass or not. I do some assumption first. 2 meter. Okay. And then my orifice will be 600 mm. Internal diameter will be 600 mm. And I want to place this orifice at the most bottom of the OST. So 2 meter minus 0.3 meter is 1.7. But the diameter just now is internal diameter. So 1.7 meter, I give you some tolerance, become 1.6 up because the orifice has material thickness. Okay, and then the diameter, I put back 600 mm. And then the program will do back calculation, recommend the number of orifice needed. Okay, it recommend 1, so I keep 1, 2 also can. Okay. And then the secondary outlet, maintain the 50 years. Normally it is 50 years. And key in the value for broad crystal beam and the height of the overflow. This engineer also needs to assume what is the height of the overflow. And then click calculate the problem we propose, the wheel width. Wheel width, this is the wheel. And the wheel width is perpendicular to this diagram. And the required storage. This storage is by using the maximum value, this one, times 1.2. Then we get the required storage. This is the storage we need to provide. Then we go on to quantum killing. Then we determine we need to design a rectangular or circular. Let's say rectangular. And to propose the dimension, try and arrow, see pass or not. The depth, previously I assumed 2 meter, now I keep in back 2 meter. This one changes to below ground. Okay, let's see enough or not. Click calculate, enough. If not enough, what will happen? It will give an error message. Please recalculate the volume. So, I'll use that. The proper dimension. And click calculate. And then the pipe discharge. Choose the combination of the pipe, size of the pipe, and the radius of the pipe. Try and error. If no message pop up, then it means it's okay. Then can click this button, analyze. Then 4 output will be generated, it's a texture report. All the detailed calculation. It will indicate what formula being used, and what values is being substituted inside the formula, and what chart is being referred to. All the indicating here, so the user can go through the calculation here. And the summary report summarize all the important design results from texture report. Very short. Okay, and the detailing for below ground OST. The basic detailing for underground for below ground OST. Maybe all need to be touched up according to the design requirement or design specification. And this is the graph. IDF. Graph for pre-development. IDF graph for post-development. The purpose of the IDF graph is to get the rainfall intensity. This is the storm duration. And this is the rainfall intensity. This is the ARIU retriever, depends on which ARIU. And this is the storm duration versus SSR. This graph is plotted out by using the radian. This table. So we can see that there's a maximum value around here. So that's all for OST. We will have a mini break of 5 minutes. Later on, we'll continue back on quant design. Thank you.